Good morning, Crestview. I'm Trevor.
And I'm Channing.
It's Friday, March 8th, and it's an A day.
It's finally time.
Time for what?
The Crestview Shadow Boxing Challenge with Chris.
Hey, this is my segment! This is my segment! Move out the way! It's time to shadow box!
Alright, guys, so we're gonna start off with something clean for the first shadow box. Alright, so we're going against a lucky sixth grader that wanted to shadow box, and he thought he could cook me. Oh, he almost cooked me, but it's alright, guys. I'm gonna win fair and square! Alright, so, I cooked him. Oh my god. Look at the. Oh my god. Grand hitters! Alright, good game, sir. Good game. Oh, thanks for the crown, Brent. I appreciate that. I'm King Chris. Alright, you watch it. You saw it.
Good job to all the people who shadowboxed me. Try again next year. That's how you shadowbox.
Crestview students participated in the National History Day at UMSL, and six of the students finished first in their categories and advanced to the state competition that's coming up April 27th at Mizzou.
So we have 6th, 7th, and 8th graders that are involved in the science poll, and right now it is sponsored by me, Ms. Pace, and Mrs. Sid.
What is the science poll?
So science poll is a competition where you're competing with other students on a team against another team from a different school, and you want to have the most points after answering questions.
Who was in it?
Just a bunch of students from your school from different grades.
So the science poll is a competition where we answer questions that are about physical science, earth science, there's some general science, energy, math, and biology. So throughout the year we've been meeting in either room 411 or 407 to practice. And then we had a scrimmage, which is kind of like a practice competition at Bayer's campus. And then for the actual competition, that was at WashU this past weekend. The competition was Saturday, and we've been meeting on Wednesdays and Thursdays in order to prepare for competition. So the students really enjoy playing it. They get to show off all of their knowledge about science, and I think they enjoy the competition. So anybody can stay. This Thursday is going to be a celebration for our competitors, so we aren't gonna take any new members at that time. But in the following meetings, you are all welcome to come and check it out and see what it's about so you can see how you can be a part of it next year.
He's got 20 seconds. Ladies and gentlemen, we're getting there. 5.5 minutes for 3 days of Chick-fil-A. You gotta be kidding me.
Seven,
come on!
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
He's going! He's did it! He did it! Look at that! Look at that! He did it! 5.5 minutes hanging on the ball, Lucas Tay. You are a legend, son. You are a legend. 3 days of Chick-fil-A. Lucas, come over here. I'm gonna interview you. Lucas. You're in front of all your peers right now. What'd that feel like?
I don't know.
What's it feel like to be a legend here at Crestview?
I don't know. I was just doing it.
We've been around for 70 years, son, and nobody's ever hung that long. You're the only one. How do you feel right now?
Good, I guess.
You feel like a champion?
I don't know.
Yeah, you feel like a champion? You feel like Travis Kelce right now?
No, I'm not really.
Hey, give it up, baby. Lucas Tay!
Channing, did you know that St. Patrick's Day is this week?
Yep, and I've got my green all ready. Let's see how Crestview plans to celebrate.
Cut.
I celebrate St. Patrick's Day. Me and my family love building, leprechaun traps. And we have, a giant Zoom meeting with, all of our cousins.
I celebrate St. Patrick's Day by going Chicago every year and seeing the big river turn green.
On St. Patrick's Day, my family goes outside and plays kickball.
I celebrate St. Patrick's Day by eating corned beef and eating cabbage.
For St. Patrick's Day, I just like wear a crown so I don't get pinched by people.
For St. Patrick's Day, we go on a picnic sometimes at the park.
We're making an arcade style game. So basically, you know when you go to like movie theaters, like arcade places, and you have those like big machines that have the joystick and like the button set up? We're basically making that, and there's like software group, but the hard
X and Y is not on each bag.
It's
Trevor, did you know we have a new therapy dog here at Crestview?
Yeah, his name's Bodie.
Let's find out some more about how we can help Bodie during his training as a therapy dog.
This is Bodie, Crestview's newest therapy dog. He's still learning how to be a therapy dog, so here are a few things to remember as he trains to be the best therapy dog he can be.
Don't talk too loudly when you're around him. Try to walk and not run near him. Bodie needs his space, so don't get too close to Bodie.
Ask Mr. Frost before you try to play with Bodie. If Mr. Frost says it's okay to pat Bodie, only pat him on the back, chest, and only one person at a time. Thank you for all your help as Bodie gets used to Crestview.
We're back with more.
More of what?
More of Crestview's Cribs, Front Desk Edition.
What's in your crib?
All right, hey guys, I'm Mr. Baca. Come around over here. I'm gonna show you the Welcome Center. This is where everybody checks in. We have school pass right here. Students, parents, visitors, staff all sign in here. Let's go around to the other side. On the other side, we have our computer so we can see everybody that's signed in, look at schedules. There's our phone, and this is our phone that has a button to let people in and out of the school. That's my crib.
And while you're checking out the front desk, check for your lost stuff in the lost and found in the cafeteria.
Have you lost a coat, a hoodie, or a water bottle? If you have, come take a walk with me over to the lost and found. That's okay. See you later, Crestview.
It's a sad picture.
else gets what you wanted, it can't end. You know it's all the same, another time and place, repeating history, and you're getting sick of it. But I believe in whatever you do, and I'll do anything to see it through, because these things will change. Can you feel it? These walls that they put up to hold us back will fall down. This revolution, the time will come for us to finally win. And we'll sing hallelujah. We'll sing hallelujah.
Inclusion means that everybody in the space feels valid, that they can access what we're learning and feel some level of success, that everybody feels welcome, everybody feels like they have a voice, and that their stories and their perspectives are heard, and they also see themselves in the materials that are being taught.
I think inclusion means to like make sure that like everyone's included, and to make sure that no one feels left out. Like, if you're talking about something, include someone else in it, and don't like be like rude about it, and don't let them not talk in it.
What does inclusion mean to you?
To me, inclusion means that everyone is celebrated for their own unique strengths, and also you are not assuming that what's normal for you has to be normal for everyone else.
So inclusion means making sure that every single person feels welcome in the part of or in the community.
To be included basically means to bring somebody into your group, to be nice to them. Like, to, if they're alone, you gotta bring them in and help them out, you know?
Have a great day, Crestview!
This has been a Crestview Curtain Call production.
Made at Crestview! Woo-hoo.